Kajabi continues to be my favorite all-in-one online business tool. Within the Kajabi page builder, there are a lot of great options and features for you to collect leads, such as opt-in pages, opt-in forms. You can get people directly on your email list. And today we're going to talk about one of those great features, which are the exit pop-ups and the page pop-ups. Now, if you're new to Kajabi and you've never used it before, you're in luck because I'd like to offer you a free 30-day trial simply by going to michaelgoms.com/Kajabi. You'll find the link in the description below. And if you sign up for that free 30-day trial, I'm also going to offer you a bundle of bonuses. So check that out. Go to michaelgoms.com/Kajabi and get your free 30-day trial today. I'm Mike Goms, and I created this channel to help aspiring entrepreneurs like yourself find more financial time and location freedom by turning your knowledge and your passions into a thriving online business. So if you haven't done so yet and you want more tutorials just like this one, subscribe to my channel to get notified when they are released. So inside the Kajabi page builder, there are two main options for pop-up forms. There's the exit pop-up form, which we're going to go over a little bit, and there's the main page pop-up form. And I want to talk about some of the caveats to using these forms and how, depending on which page you're actually setting the form up on, how it's going to work. After you signed up with Kajabi and you have accessed your dashboard, you're going to go over here on the left-hand side, which is where we are, under the website design tab. This is your home page. I'm going to use this as our example. So I'm going to mouse over and we're going to go to customize page and we're going to click on that. And for those of you who are new or not familiar where to find the pop-ups, it's over here down the left-hand side. This is your sections right here. You're just going to scroll to the bottom of your sections in the page builder. And down here, you will see exit pop-up and two-step opt-in pop-up. And we're going to talk about both of these. We're here right now on my homepage. This is a homepage that I'm currently building. I'm actually using a landing page currently temporarily for my homepage while I build out this homepage. And we know that by, if we come up here to the top, you can see this drop-down menu right here. And if I click on this drop-down menu, you can see that home is selected. Now you see all these other pages here. These are what they call system pages. So any changes you make to the settings or the color, the design, fonts, things like that, to the button colors, not necessarily on this page individually, but in the settings, the main settings for the site, are gonna change across all of these pages on your site. And what's great about that is that it helps you to, you know, kind of set it and forget it. Set the settings one time in the back end and then have those settings kind of distribute all the way across all of your main website system pages. If you create a separate landing page, you're going to have control individually over those settings for that landing page specifically, including the exit pop-ups and the two-step opt-ins. So if you're setting up any of your pop-ins on any of these pages, it doesn't matter which one. It's gonna distribute the same across all of the system pages, but not your landing pages. Does that make sense? For example, if I jump over here to my library page, as you can see here on the left-hand side, you have the exit pop-up and the two-step opt-in. This is where you're always gonna find them. But on this page, it's the exact same one as on the homepage. So we could technically just edit it here on this page. And if we go to my blog setup page, you can see here, exit pop-up and two-step opt-in. It's exactly the same. And this is the exact same one. Now, if you are on a landing page creating one, it's going to be the same process. And they're going to be located in the exact same spot right below the website sections in the page builder. But right now, I'm just going to teach you how to set up these opt-ins across your system pages. So we're only going to create one at this point. So we're going to come down here to the left-hand side. We're going to click on exit pop-up. Let's start with the exit pop-up. Now, as you notice, there is no exit pop-up, and this is what throws a lot of people off. On the left-hand side here in the exit pop-up menu, you see these two options near the top. One, we don't even have the pop-up enabled, but even if we did, in order to edit the pop-up though, it's not going to show up here unless we check this box that says edit exit pop-up. So this is a pop-up that I designed a couple of months ago that I'm currently not using. This is for my Aspiring Entrepreneur Academy, which is coming soon, that I'm currently working on. And this is a really simple built pop-up, even though it looks a little complicated. As you can see here in the page builder, we have an image and we have a form. Now this text, this main body of text here, is actually part of the form. For the purpose of this video and to keep it kind of short, we're actually going to focus today on the functionality of these pop-ups and not the design itself. So let's start with this left sidebar menu. So this is very similar to the page builder that you saw on the previous page. If I want to add more content to this pop-up, I can select add content. Now, they don't give you as many options here to add content as they do in the main page builder for your website, but that's okay. We have a lot of great options here. One, we can add a video. So if I were to click on this, As you can see here, it adds a video to the bottom of the pop-up, right? And if we go over here and we click back and we want to drag this video up to the top to maybe replace this image, then we can have a video play there instead of an image. The other types of content we have here are, you know, buttons, call to action, which are separate than the forms. And then of course we have forms. Now let me remove this video real quick, delete this. Now the next setting I want to show you are the exit pop-up settings. If you're not familiar with exit pop-ups are when people try to leave your website with the intent to actually leave. So if they mouse up basically anywhere near the top, near the header, it's going to trigger this pop-up. It's usually those pop-ups that say something like, wait, hold off, before you leave, I want to give you this offer, or wait, before you leave, sign up for my newsletter, sign up for my webinar, or something like that. So this pop-up at this point, the way the settings currently are, should only appear if someone tries to basically leave your webpage. Now, one thing that most people don't know, and this is kind of an advanced Kajabi feature, is you know those pop-ups that show up on your site when you've been on there for a certain amount of time? They have actually put this setting underneath the exit pop-up as well. So if we go under time reveal, I usually set this to show up after 3 seconds. If you mouse over this little information icon, it'll actually explain it to you a little bit more. So for 5 minutes, is 300 seconds. So if you want the pop-up to actually just automatically pop up, then you want to enter the 300 seconds. Now, it's going to show this pop-up whether someone's been on there for 5 minutes or whether someone tries to leave your website. So basically, whichever one comes first. Let's come over here and click save so we don't lose our progress. Now I want to kind of show you how this works on the actual web page. But in order to do that, come over here to the left-hand side. These are two things that you have to make sure you do before you actually are done. You need to first check enable exit pop-up. So that actually turns on the pop-up. So it'll actually show up on the pages. And then you need to uncheck the edit exit pop-up. And then come over here to the right-hand side and choose save again. Now, if we click here to preview this page, and if we wait 5 seconds, or sorry, 3 seconds, there you go. There's the pop-up. Now I'm also going to show you how it works as an exit intent. So I'm going to go ahead and refresh this page real quick. And then I'm going to try to mouse up here to the top. Boom. The moment I went towards to close that window is when it pops up. So that's how it works. Real simple, but very effective. Now let's talk about two-step opt-in pop-ups. So let's go back here, go down to the bottom. Let's go into the two-step opt-in. Now it's the same idea here, right? That right now it's currently not turned on for editing purposes. So let's turn that on so we can see it. And here we're just starting with a blank pop-up so I can show you from scratch how to build this. Now what a two-step pop-up is that basically it's a pop-up that you can link to any call to action button link on your web pages. So let me just show you real quick again, adding content. It's the same idea. Let's say we want to add an image. Let's just add an image. We'll select something recent. Let's see. Let's just grab an image of myself. Okay, there we go. Let's go back. Maybe we want to add also in a form. Select form. Come down here. Okay, so right here, it's going to not show the form. It's going to say click here to see the form to display. If we come over here on the left-hand side, it says form. Just click the drop-down. You can select the form. Let's just choose the same one. Well, let's see. Yeah, let's do our main newsletter one. This one will look a little different. There you go. So there's our main newsletter form. After they sign up for whatever it is that I'm offering here, I can also right here send them to a custom thank you page, which is also great. A lot of people don't do this, but instead of having one of those custom thank you pages that just says, hey, thanks for your submission, go check your email inbox and, you know, we sent you your freebie there. Take advantage of this thank you page and link them to a page that actually will promote one of your next products. Or if you've ever heard of a self-liquidating offer, that's basically where you're giving away a freebie in your pop-up. They're signing up for it. So once they sign up for it here, you're redirecting them to a thank you page where you're offering them something small, like a tiny offer, something that's like $7, $17, $10, something like that. So if you click on this drop-down arrow, you can send them to a custom landing page, something you've already set up. You can send them directly to a checkout page if you just want to have them get the freebie and send them somewhere to purchase something. That's another option. And here you can actually just select download a file and you can upload a PDF so that once they enter their email address, they can instantly download the PDF right from here. Obviously right here, this is where you'd customize the text, everything that would basically show up in the body over here of the pop-up. This is your disclaimer text. If we were to put, you know, like, I don't know, copyright or something. There you go. Shows up right below the button. If you want to make your form more inline instead of stacked like this, just check this inline box. There you go. So again, we're not getting into the design features on this right now, just more of the functionality. So that's how you set up your form. Now we're going to go up here and we're going to go back on the left-hand side. And then remember, when you're done, you need to uncheck the edit the two-step pop-up. Now, notice how I didn't say anything about how you have to save a link or anything to this pop-up to link to your calls to actions or your buttons, because I'm going to show you how super simple it is to do that right after this. So uncheck this edit two-step pop-up, and then let's click save in the upper right-hand corner. All right, now that that's saved, let's find a button here to add this pop-up to. Let's go to our podcast button here. So we're going to click on this listen on your favorite player. And over here on the left-hand side, it opens the menu. And as you can see here right now, I currently have the button action to select go to a URL, which is the URL for my podcast, the Aspiring Entrepreneur Podcast. So what I'm going to do is click the drop down arrow. And as you can scroll down here, you get a lot of different options. And you can see here, open two-step opt-in pop-up. So that's the one that we just created. And again, it's going to be the same across all your system pages. But if this was a landing page, if I built a landing page, go ahead and watch my landing page video, which is on my YouTube channel. I'll link it in the description below. But if you build a landing page, you're going to be able to have a separate two-step opt-in pop-up here that is different than the one across the rest of the pages on your website. So let's click on open two-step pop-up, and I'm going to show you this. Let's click save. Now let's click preview again right here on the left of the save button. Click the button. And there's our pop-up. There's the one that we created. So again, you can assign this pop-up to any call to action or any button anywhere on your site. So I hope this video has been helpful in helping you understand a little bit more about the different pop-ups and options that you have available on your website. Like I said before, if you haven't done so already, subscribe to my channel to get notified of future Kajabi or other tutorials. And if you have any questions, I am here to help. Just ask anybody. I love answering questions. So comment below, ask your questions, and I'll get right to them. Have a great day, and we'll see you in the next video.